unboxing video of this Weber 1200, whatever it is, barbecue. Like usual, this is an unscripted video. So, there'll be some stumbling and some bumbling as I figure out, of course, the plan. I have a plan. My plan is to shoot a video of opening this thing up and just to see how that goes. So, trusty knife. Trusty knife here. Cut this open and see what's inside. I have a whole barbecue for years. Some pictures of it on Facebook, maybe it's had it going the other day. So old, over 20 years old, it's just not good anymore. Set it up. This is portable. Smaller, it'll fit on the table, which is the one complaint I had for my old one. Big, and for the type of cooking that I do, I don't really need much. Anyhow, enough of that. Let's see what's in there. That's the justification you see for buying this thing. So, cardboard packaging. Now, oh my goodness, this is a Canadian edition. I did want the orange one. And there's only one orange one left. It's open, dirty, so I took the box. That's what the inside of the box looks like. Register your grill. I didn't know that. You can go online. Your grill can be online. What's this instructions? It's assembly instructions. Who needs those? Yeah, they're there. I mean, I'm being funny, but I assembly instructions? This? I mean, it's a Canadian barbecue. I'm Canadian. I should be able to do this with my eyes closed. So, let's see how it goes. Plan B. Same as plan A, which is see how it goes, eh? Yeah, man. There, take that off, put that off, and open that thing. This is old. Oh, wait, outdoor cooking, specialty, gas, appliance, design. Certified under CISIS of 2013. Okay. I'm thinking that's the manufacturer date anyways. This is probably a 13 model. So it's been around a while. Maybe not. Any other indications of manufacturer date on the box? Something to look for, you know, when you buy something, even if it's on sale. It could be new, old stock. Meaning it's the same as brand new stuff, but it's 3 or 4 years old. This is from 13, it's already 4 years old. She's saying, what's the big deal? Well, plastics have an age, they deteriorate after so much time. Perhaps this one's already getting creaky. Who knows? That's the thing about buying stuff on sale. Anyhow, what else have we got here? I'm going to build this. So you're going to sit with me while I build it. That's how it's. assemble it. Camera, I'll show you the assembly process. So I'm already learning how to do this. See how smart I'm getting? So this is a everybody covers things. Can't box in. There. That one on. There. X number of what pounds? Enough. That was fancy. Okay, so what's next? Following the instructions that I'm not following. So, I'm seeing a knob location. And it's your basic press on fair, line up the thing with the thing, put it on, let arm draw power. It feels kind of okay, I guess. You have a solid feel, maybe. Okay, so what's next is the igniter. You know, I've cut myself with it. Sharp knife here. Found that knife on a workbench. It was all dinged and black. And looks just like a piece of junk. The handle was loose and everything. It's really good old school German steel, Solingen, and it's sharp as death and all that kind of stuff. So, I think I remember that from seeing it in the store. Go. Who's that? Who's that? Right there. I didn't get any of those bottles, and I have the old propane tank from the barbecue. I have three of them. Three. And I can exchange those for refills or get them done at Costco for cheap. They're really, it's $10 to fill them. $10, it's 50 cents a pound for propane in here like this, and it's $6 a pound if you buy the little bottles. So go figure. Or $7. It's crazy expensive. So what I have here is this 4-foot propane hose and adapter. This didn't come with it. I bought this separately. Okay, so this is the next thing we're going to look at. We open this up, and I tried these one of these out in the store, and I'm pretty sure that this will plug that thing into one of those. So So that's the next thing to do, is sell that house. So why don't we, how would we make this take this focus? Open this up. In case you're noticing the scratch on my hand, that's what I got for brushing my cat this morning. Grateful skank. She caught me. I'm good. Okay, so that's all. Let's turn this around. Don't do this at home. Consult a professional. Okay, so let's see here. Wouldn't recommend lighting it with the plastic trays on the inside. That's probably not a good idea either. I wonder how long it's going to take me to do that. So, where's the igniter thing? There. Hear that? So I'm going to assume, oh wait, here, lighting instructions. Should we read them together? Let's read them together. That way you know I actually got instructions. Turn that. Lighting instructions. Read instructions before lighting. Open lid during lighting. Push control knob again and turn to start high. Press igniter button. If ignition does not occur in 5 seconds, turn the burner and go off. Wait 5 minutes and repeat the lighting procedure. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. I won't even wait 5 seconds. Come on, let's go. Wait 5 minutes. That's ignite high. Wow, it's on. That's slick. The only way to tell us it was. Thermometer move. And we'll do that when it's ready. Yeah, it's coming up already. That's pretty awesome. I think I like it. So, there you go. That's the unboxing and the assembling and the turning on video of the Weber, or is it Weber? I'd say Weber Q1200 portable gas barbecue. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you want to get one of these, you better hurry up because they're going fast.